Hello students of class 6th. Today's video is in continuation with the second chapter of science. The name of the chapter is Components of Food. This is the fourth video on this chapter, Components of Food. Now, we might be interested to test if a particular food item contains fats or not. So you take some butter, and if you are asked whether it contains fats, so I think now you are more confident that you will be able to check it. But how? Let's have a look. Fats are oily substances, that is, they contain oil. Whether we talk about butter or ghee or cheese, all of them contain oil. So presence of oily patch on paper indicates the presence of fat. So for fat, you do not need any solution or anything to test. All you need is a piece of paper. So you take a piece of paper, put the sample of food item on the paper. Let's say you have taken a fried egg. So you have fried the egg in sufficient amount of oil, and now you have kept the fried egg on a piece of paper and you have wrapped the egg with this piece of paper. Now after some time, let the paper dry. You remove the egg from the paper and you allow the paper to dry. What happens? You see that that portion of the paper where the egg was kept, that becomes slightly translucent. So opaque is that substance through which we cannot see. If you have a piece of paper with you, it will block the object behind that paper and you will not be able to see what is there behind the paper. But through translucent object, you will be able to slightly see what is there behind the paper. Example, a glass window. You can easily see through the glass window, right? Even if it is closed. Similarly, for translucent, you cannot completely see what is there on the other side, but partially you can see. So here in this case, you can see that that part of the paper which was in contact with the fatty substance, it became translucent. So you can feel the difference between the texture of the two parts of the paper. You can see it on your screen also. This proves that the substance contains fat. You think of any substance like French fries, pastries, etc. The moment you'll keep them on the sheet of paper, you will see that oily patch on the paper. Okay, you can see that oily patch on the paper, like you can see on your screen also. There is an oily patch which is marked as translucent. Now, if that substance contains too much of fat, that means it contains too much of oily substance in it. So what will happen? Then the oily patch, this oily patch on the paper would also be more. Okay, it is more denser. You can, it will become more translucent. Now, if the substance contains less amounts of fat, what will happen? That is, you might have fried something in something, you have shallow fried something. So it must have contained less amount of fats. Okay, then oily patch would also be less. So this oily patch proves that the test is positive. So for these, we would say that the test is positive. Now, various other substances for which fat test would come out to be positive are oil, French fries, butter, frimes which are fried in oil, or any item which are deep fried in oil, they would result in extremely positive fat test. Those which are shallow fried, they also contain oil but in lesser amount. So fat test is again very effective. That was about the fat test for various substances. In this, you saw that it is very easy for us to find out that whether a particular substance contains proteins or carbohydrates or fats. We have performed the test for all the three of these. So now that we have learned about all of these three, that is the carbohydrates, proteins and fats, so let's test for different food items. So let's consider milk. It is a very rich source of proteins, so it gives a positive test for proteins. You think of spinach. It also contains proteins, but not in very large quantities, but in moderate amounts. You think of ground nuts. They contain proteins. They also contain fats. That is, I have told you that one food item may contain more than one nutrient. So bread contains a lot of carbohydrates, so it will give a positive test for carbohydrates. You think of rice, it also gives a positive test for carbohydrates. Pulses, they definitely give a positive test for proteins. Potato, they are again rich in carbohydrates, so they will give you a positive starch test. Boiled egg contain a lot of protein, they also contain some amounts of healthy fat. So we can plan our diet according to the nutrients present in the food items we prefer to consume. I hope the test for fats is clear to all of you. Thank you, students, for hearing me so patiently. Go through this video, try to understand it, and if you have any query, do write us on the WhatsApp number of the school.